always it is the process of origin of a new species. Okay, it is always the process of origin of a new species. So what is species actually? So species means a group of organisms which are mostly similar and the characters are similar, and then the members of the species are able to interbreed among themselves. So they are the group of organisms who have similar characters and are capable of interbreeding, that means mating among each other and production of new species. And then it is also important that the newly produced species should be a fertile offspring. So why is it necessary? So it is always important that the newly produced offspring should also be fertile. Okay, then speciation happens. When does speciation actually happen? So speciation happens when two groups of same species are somehow prevented from interbreeding over the generations. So speciation means here when two group of the same species are not allowed or not prevented from interbreeding or mating or reproducing the new variety. If they are prevented from mating over the period of few generations, then it is known as the speciation. So in the speciation, the two group of the same species are prevented from mating or interbreeding with each other. So why does actually speciation occurs? So speciation occurs because of the geographical segregation. That means, see, there is something called allopatric speciation. That means what? Suppose due to any natural changes. See, let's take an example of beetles. You know beetles. Beetles live on bushes, right? So beetles actually live in bushes. Bushes are small trees and they feed on the leaves of the bushes. But suppose if these bushes are spread over the large mountain ranges, then over the mountains totally there will be bushes, and then there will be a large population of beetles from this corner to that corner. But that group of beetle, one group of beetle will stay in a one particular area only and will feed in this particular area. It cannot travel from one corner of the mountain to another corner of the mountain, right? So this is the main population of the beetles in one corner of the mountain, and in the neighborhood it will be having subpopulations. So who will interbreed? Obviously the people of the subpopulation will interbreed with each other. That is, people of the same species will interbreed with each other. They will not go for the purpose of mating from one corner to other corner, right? So, but sometimes there may be another instances, such as, see, if one beetle has a nature of adventure activity, then one beetle will travel to another corner of the mountain and then it will interact with the local population of the another corner of the mountain, and then it will develop into a new species. And suppose, see, if there has been any atmospheric changes and there is a river flow has been created, a river has been flowing between these two, one single mountain has been broken into two parts. Why? Because there was a formation of the river. And then what happens? The beetles from the one half of the mountain cannot go to the another half of the mountain because there is a river flowing in the between. And then the beetles on the left side of the mountain cannot interact with the beetles with the right side of the mountain. And then they develop changes between them, that are the variations. Then that is what known as the geographical segregation. Geography is what is happening in the surroundings. What has happened in the surroundings? A river was created separating the mountain into two halves, due to which the beetles couldn't go from one part of the mountain to another. And then that is the reason they segregated and isolated and developed into a new species. So that is one cause of the speciation, that is the geographical segregation. So geographical segregation always leads to the evolution of new species, which leads to the genetic drift. Genetic drift means small changes in a subpopulation. Okay, and then these genetic changes also occur when there is geographical segregation. What are the genetic changes? See, beetles on the left side of the mountain have separate genes and beetles on the right side of the mountain have different genes. They have different gene flow. Their DNA will be changed, the structure of the DNA will change, and then the number of chromosomes, germ cells, all these will change. So over a period of generations, the beetles present on the left side of the mountain cannot interbreed or cannot mate with the beetles on the right side of the mountain, because they both have isolated, they have developed variations, and then now they are isolated into two separate species with two separate characteristics. That means the gene flow has changed, the structure of the DNA has changed, and the number of the chromosomes, germ cells has also changed. So that is how isolation happens and new species develop. Even though they are related, but they have distinct characters. So that is where species arise. So what is actually, how do organisms are divided? So in science, the organisms, the closeness of an organism is always divided into two sublevels. See, beetles are present both on the left side and the right side of the mountain. Both are beetles, but now because of segregation, isolation, they have separate characteristics. They cannot interbreed with each other. So on what basis are actually organisms classified? So in the science, there are two sublevels of closeness of an organism. That is known as genus and species. For example, human beings. Human beings belong to the genus Homo. And we human beings belong to the species Homo sapiens. But earlier, over 100 years ago, millions of years ago, there were other species also. Homo, Neanderthals. Like that, there were other species also. But all these are extinct now. They no longer exist. All of them have kicked the bucket. So the only species of the genus Homo living today on the earth is Homo sapiens. So that is what makes us unique. We are the only species of the genus Homo who are surviving on the earth today. And what are the distinct characteristics we have? We have a huge brain which helps us to think, which helps us to do maths, understand science and all the other subjects, right? So that is how an organism is classified. All the organisms belong to the same genus, but then the species are different. See, for example, we say that chimpanzee have been evolved from the human being. So somewhere human beings and chimpanzee are interrelated. That is, the genus of the human beings and chimpanzee are interrelated, but the species is different. Like that, an organism is always classified into two types. So, and what are the types of speciation? There is sympatric speciation. Sympatric speciation means of different country. Suppose in a country, there are beetles, but the beetles are living on many corners of the country. So all of the beetles on different corners of the country have different characteristics. They have different variations. They cannot interbreed with each other. Though they are living in the same country and they are in the different corners of the same country, they cannot breed with each other. So that is sympatric speciation, that is species of the same country. And then we have peripatric speciation. Peripatric means near. Peri means near. So organisms which are living nearer to each other will also have different species among them. Then parapatric speciation. Parapatric speciation means distance. So organisms which are living away from each other, which are distanced from each other, also have some amount of new species formed in them because of the variation. See, for example, sometimes behavior changes. So parapatric speciation may also be known as the behavioral speciation. How? See, for example, on an island there are two groups of beetles, but the food habits of the beetles are different. One type of organism likes a hotter climate and one type of organism may like a colder climate. And the food habits of these two organisms may be different. But see, they all belong to the same family, that is, they all belong to the same genus. But then the behavioral changes also lead to the evolution of two separate species. And then these two separate species cannot interbreed with each other. That is, they cannot produce a new fertile offspring. See, speciation will lead to, what is speciation now? Speciation happens when two groups of the same species are somehow prevented from interbreeding. It is always important that two persons who are interbreeding should produce a fertile offspring. What happens if they do not produce the fertile offspring? It doesn't continue to generation. See, for example, mule. We know mule, right? When we cross a donkey with a horse, we get mule. But mule is not a fertile. Mule is not fertile. See, for example, a male lion is crossed with a female tiger. Then what we get, you know, organism? We get a liger. Lion, male lion plus female tiger. We get a liger. That is a new organism. But that is not fertile. It cannot produce babies again. Same way, if you cross a donkey with a horse, we get mule. But mule is not a fertile organism. It cannot reproduce. And and mule doesn't have any specific number of chromosomes or any specific DNA structure. So it is important that two persons who are mating should always produce a fertile offspring, so that the fertile offspring is also able to produce babies. So that is how speciation is important. So species means a group of organisms whose characters are similar, and those members of the species are capable of mating with each other and producing a fertile offspring. Production of fertile offspring is important, right? In the production, that leads to the production of new species, right? So geographical segregation, see, because the river has separated the mountain into two halves, the beetles could develop new characteristics among themselves, and they could develop new variations. Thereby, they evolve into a new species. They are isolated and evolve into a new species. So this is how speciation occurs.